Are you a venture capital founder? Do you have a community that you want to take care of and showcase how amazing everything you got going on is? Well, good for you. We actually have a venture capital founders community template in our Softr template list that you can actually see by going to softr.io/templates, a myriad of different templates that allow you to service people in your teams and outside of it in a multitude of ways. What this template offers is a lot of different amazing features ranging from user permissions for LPs, founders and admins, company profiles and founder profiles, some job listings, LP updates, and events. Now that's not all of it, but if we do want to take a look at it quickly, we can actually press preview on this template, similar to what you can do with all of our other templates. And this will give you a look at what this template is all about. I'm really excited to dive into this. Let's get going. So first, what we're going to do is press Use Template. After we press Use Template, what then we can do is add it to our data source. I'm personally going to pick Airtable and then press Copy Base to my Airtable account. After that, all we got to do is press Add Base. And then in a moment, once this finishes adding it to the base, let's go back to our Softr account and press Create Application. This will sync it up so that we have things on both ends here. Now, you'll take a glance here and see that we have a litany of different members with those different roles we talked about. So founder is one user, group role, admin's another, and then limited partner or LP is another. So then we have a myriad of different tables outside of this. We have one for events, the attendees of those events, companies themselves, different teams, so like team members and then the companies they're a part of, job opportunities, so those job listings like I talked about earlier, perks at those companies, and then company updates. So right here, what we have inside of our template is we can press go to application. Once it's all loaded up, then we'll see that homepage that we saw earlier. Now this is a beautiful homepage, but right here, what you'll notice is a form, and that form is essentially for people to submit. And those submissions will then forward it to our email. It doesn't go to any of the different databases. It's just a forward submission so that we can hear from people when they want to get in contact. As you can see here, there are a myriad of different headers. And this one is for people who are not logged in. So let's just take a little preview of this right here. And you'll see that when we press learn more, it just brings us down to this section. And when we press contact, once again, just brings us down to that section. So these are actually just visual ones more so than actual page differences. But if I press apply, this does bring us to an application to join the founders community. You can introduce yourself and why you'd be a great member of the founders community, and you'll be notified when your profile is approved. Then you'll be able to interact with other members and attend events. So for this, if I filled this out, I would actually go into, if I go to the join the community page here, this will map into the VC community by Softr and then go to the members. So if I go to members, so it'll actually add us to the users right here. Now, so say for example, I wanted to put in Dimitri at softr.io, put Chicago, about me. I'm just a dude who likes making videos. And then maybe submit a profile picture as well. Then I can press submit here after this loads up. Then it'll bring me back to a thanks for your application page. And we can go back to the homepage too. Now, as you can see, after I refresh this, I actually do pop up within this, and it says that I'm a founder, because by default, in that form, it does have a hidden field that makes my role a founder, and then another field for mail to, and that's essentially for a formula that has a mail to formula, which is very smart, actually, sort of giving it a default value there. And the about me and all that other kind of stuff mapped in here, including images, which is very convenient. And I really got to applaud Softr. That's a very cool feature. Now, if we go into this and let's say I was approved, right? And I go to the users section here. You'll see that it's going to sync with my Airtable base. If I press refresh table and I were to look up Dimitri and give myself a good old fashioned magic link, I will view this from a signed in founder's perspective. So in this, we'll see that now that header difference I was talking about, or when you go here, you'll notice a myriad of different header options. The top one here being for admin, second one being for limited partners, and this bottom one being for founders.
As you can see, the only difference in this header is for limited partners versus founders, and admins are that they cannot see the perks page. So if I go to founders here, it'll show you a list of the different founders that are there. So what's up, I'm in the community. If I click on myself now, I can see information about me. And if I want to get in touch with this person, even though it is me, that's where that mail to option comes in. It would send that out. That's what that formula is for, essentially that button for the founder details. Was smart enough to grab in the content section a get in touch field. That was the email mail to. Very smart. I like that a lot, actually. So cool button option there. Then below, we actually just have a section that says meet other founders. So I can essentially just go through all the different founder details, see who they are, their company name, a little image right here, which is a company image, a description about them, where they're from, really nice stuff. And then this just expands to see more founders, as it is limited by 4 per page, but I can increase this to 8 if I wanted, completely up to me. If I were to, for example, publish that and refresh, by default, it would showcase 8 ones here instead of 4. Now, if I go into the company section, I also would have companies be able to be viewed here. So just by clicking inside of one of these, if I go to BTech, I'd see the different team members that are within here and any updates that are associated to it, as well as a founding date, the founder name, the website, the description, all that kind of stuff. And a really cool idea would be maybe take the founder table that we had before. So we went to founders and were to copy to put this to the company details. And I personally think what would be a nice update is, well, this team is cool, and we have the team filtered to company's company name, is that we also could do the same thing. Because I like the fact that it's got this awesome updates view and everything, but it would also be cool if you could just, for example, I'm gonna move this up one more, add a little text block, or maybe even just copy this one, duplicating it, moving it up, having it say founders, have this filtered to company name is company's company name. So that I would essentially just filter to that person and have Sasha show up as the BTech company person. So if I go inside of BTech again, pretty simple stuff, but this filter makes all the difference. Then we could actually check out different events that are within here. So for example, it showcases all the different attendees. You could type out and search out different event names, where they are. Let's do ones that are in Berlin and all. And this one pops up, but we can also just do like Prop Tech Thursdays. This one shows up. We can click on this guy and we'll see the event information. And if we want to attend, we press this button. And what it does, so we can go to the event details page and see, is it is a sales form that essentially sends data to the source and has a bunch of hidden fields. It doesn't have anything else except for the submit button. It grabs the email of the person logged in. It grabs the record ID and grabs the name of the person logged in. So you can see you wanted to go to the Prop Tech Thursdays. And if we go to events, see Prop Tech Thursdays, I'm gonna be mapped to that. So you can see Dimitri Panici. Now I'm connected to Prop Tech Thursdays. So then I'll be in the members attending section, which is very cool. Let's see, I'm right here. If I want to submit an event, I can do that. I'd put a form within here, and then that would allow me to, in a similar way, put information that then showcases inside of the events page. When it comes to the events themselves, the visibility is for everybody. And say, for example, I wanted to, I could filter it to only show approved events, because obviously once this is submitted, it's just gonna go through. And then some other different options to look at here are, if you recall, the perks page is something that I would be able to see as a founder. And you'll see I get a weekly newsletter, restaurants, American Airlines, flying's never been more enjoyable, a gym, events, and then I can see any more perks that would be listed here, which is awesome. Then clicking on it, I get the info on that food delivery or a different perk. And then you could go to the website and read more there. That's hyperlinked here. And in the job section, I can explore the different jobs. So exclusive open roles within the community companies. For example, head of innovation at this company based in London, click on it and then get more information about the role. A great spot to have a description, a short description, the status of it. And then if it's remote, it has that indication as well. And I can press apply and then it would link out to that page. And then
if I wanted to add a job, I could do so as well to have it showcased in that section. And what I think is really cool is that usually you just have a profile option when you go here, but I can also press edit my company as well. So I can edit the company that I'm a part of. So Softr here, add any updates and whatnot if I need to. And then I can also edit my profile page, which is another thing that often it's different than, you know, what you're used to be able to see. You just see the account settings on that right there. But as you can see, I'm just a dude who likes to make videos. Now, once again, the LPs just won't be able to see the perks page, but they have a similar experience overall. I think this is a really cool template if you are coming from a background in wanting to make a VC founders community. I love the way that this has so much information jam-packed into one template. I feel like we could spend hours going over this template, but if you do have any questions, make sure to leave a comment down below and let me know what your thoughts are on this video and how to improve your skills using Softr even more.